the vortex created in this room is about as close as you can get to standing in an actual tornado. But this is just smoke, dust, and dirt. Imagine when this twister actually starts ripping pieces of wood right out of a home.
It turns a neighborhood into a minefield. A minor piece of wood becomes a missile. How much damage can these 2x4s do?
Oh, I've seen these 2x4s go through 2 and 3 walls in a house.
Larry Tanner helps run Texas Tech's National Wind Institute, the premier testing ground for tornado shelters.
3, 2, 1.
Tanner launches the most common type of debris, a 15-pound piece of wood, to see if a shelter can withstand the impact at 100 miles per hour. The wood splinters in the blink of an eye, but by slowing it down, you can see the incredible force and destructive power. We saw the projectile punch right through plywood, which is stronger than the thin siding that most homes have. Well-built safe rooms can withstand flying 2x4s and larger debris, which is often heavier but slower. And those shelters don't have to be buried in the backyard. Some of the experts say the only way to survive that tornado was to get underground.
That is absolutely false.
Tanner says if the doors don't hold, it doesn't matter where the shelter is. And flying debris hurts or kills a lot of people as they're running outside to get to an underground shelter. So the National Wind Institute and FEMA advise installing a safe room inside the home.
Maybe it's your laundry room. Maybe it's your master bedroom closet.
Tanner says you get to use the room every day, which minimizes the cost. And his tests have proven it can be just as safe above ground.
So bottom line, when the winds start to whip around like this, you need to get to the closest safe spot, and that may not always be underground.